In this video, we will review the tools you will need to use for your Web 4 classes for the online lectures. The first thing you want to do is make sure you sign into Angel using Chrome. During the online lecture, it's important to use Chrome as it's the best browser to view it. If you're doing anything else in the course, such as completing homework and uploading it to Dropboxes, or taking tests, it's highly recommended you use Firefox, as it's a better option for those items. Once you're in your Angel environment, you'll want to go ahead and look for the live class lecture. It might be labeled something different depending on your instructor. Once you've clicked on it, you will come to an area that shows you upcoming sessions. I'm going to click on the one that's currently active. Your box will then open to your meeting software. It'll tell you you're joining the meeting. Once it's open, there's several things you could see. You could see a picture of your instructor here. You might see their video, which would look like this on the screen. Or you might see a file they're sharing, such as what we're seeing now on the screen. Regardless of what you see, there are several tools you'll need. First, we're going to go over the tools that allow us to communicate with the instructor. The first tool is the audio tool. If we click on Share Audio, it'll show a green area down here. This shows that our audio is active. To deactivate it, we just click again. A lot of times during lectures, your instructor may ask you to make sure your audio is muted. You'll know it's muted by the line going through it and the fact that it's white. Most instructors want to see you on video. In order to get your video, you would click on the next icon, which is Share Video. Here it'll walk you through a series of tests to ensure your video is working. As long as you see yourself, you can click on Share Video. Maybe you look a little odd because your camera's positioned different. You could always move it up and down in order to get it to the right position and then click Share Video. You'll know your video is being shared because you'll see the blue on the video icon. You'll also see your video down in the left-hand side of the screen. To deactivate that, you would just click on it again to mute the video, and you'll see the line going back through it. If you have a question or need to get the instructor's attention, you could always use the raise hand icon. When it's purple, it shows you that your hand is raised. The number indicates what number in line your hand is raised for. You can always lower the hand when you're done getting the instructor's attention by clicking on it again. Maybe we need to chat with our instructor or ask a question. To do that, we would come over here to the two arrows and click on it. The first icon here is chat. We could say something here like, you will see that your item will appear in the chat here. Your instructor or someone else in the class could answer that chat, and you would see the answers and responses here. Remember, if the instructor is sharing a document or a PowerPoint and lecturing, it may not be the best time to ask questions. You might want to wait till they're finished, as they won't necessarily see the chat menu while they're sharing a document. This also can be distracting, chatting during a lecture to other students. The next thing we can look at is we can look at the participant list. To do that, we click on the second here. This shows us who's in our session. We have some settings in this area also. If you're having a difficult time hearing your instructor, you might want to go to the settings and adjust your speaker volume. If you have your microphone on and they can't hear you, again, go into your settings here and adjust your microphone volume. The last tool we will review is how to make our content appear a little bit larger on our screen. There are times where it might be difficult to read a document your instructor has loaded. There's a couple quick ways to do that. First is to go up to the second row of icons and click on Show View Controls. You can use the plus sign to zoom in and the minus sign to zoom out. This particular one here does best fit on your screen. If you need a quick way to just double the size, all you would do is select the document and double click, and it'll make it larger for you.